Good morning. So my PhD is about the ecological impacts of myrtle rust on native communities. And in this chapter of my thesis, as Bob said before, there are more than 350 native species that are susceptible in Australia. And a lot of these populations were healthy before myrtle rust arrived, and now they are in danger, like Rhodomyrtus cereoides and Rhodamnia rubescens. And after a paper of Catherine Berthon, one of the research assistants in our lab, she did a modeling paper and realized that a lot of endangered species, species that were already threatened before myrtle rust arrival, have a high overlap distribution with myrtle rust, but we don't know if they are susceptible, so we wanted to test them. So we tested 22 species, 16 of them are endangered, 6 are not endangered yet, but have a high distribution overlap as well with myrtle rust. And we tested a genus for the first time, Triplarina, to see if it's susceptible as well. And we also tested 6 different provenances and subspecies to assess for intraspecific variability. So on the left, the pictures on the left are the scales of susceptibility. We had 4 scales. The first one, the green, is resistant, so no symptoms of infection. Yellow is low susceptibility, so you can see some spots or flecks, meaning hypersensitive reaction, but no development of pustules with uridinia. The medium, that is the orange one, medium susceptibility, we start seeing pustules with uridinia, and the high susceptibility, we see a lot of pustules with uridinia in most of the leaves. So the results from the 22 species that we tested, we got seeds from botanical gardens, and we grew them in the glasshouses and inoculated them. And we found that 15 of these species are susceptible to myrtle rust. 12 of them are endangered. And we didn't find differences between subspecies or provenances. So in the figure, you can see that on the left, all the green species are resistant. And then other species show all the scales of susceptibility. So that resistance is optimistic, is a great opportunity to look for resistant genes for these threatened species. Then highly susceptible species like Eucalyptus copulans and Eucalyptus parvula, the ones that have red, big red lines. For these, the myrtle rust should be considered as a major additional threat and control measures incorporated in the existing threatened species plans. And the fact that these species were tested susceptible in the lab doesn't necessarily mean that they are susceptible in the field. So the next step would be to undertake field observations to assess for the real impact of myrtle rust on the native communities. Thank you.